Okay, everyone, we're back. We're still up here on the mountain. We are heading back to town at this point. And we have a lot to get done, actually. I'm hoping that it doesn't make me immediately head off towards the temple. Because there are some things that I want to do first. Places we gotta go. People we gotta see. Conversations to have. So. Why are there cows in this cave? Why are there cows here? I tried to grab a yak and see how it tasted, and it knocked me flat on my back. You tried to bite a living yak? I know when I'm beaten. I promise to take good care of them. Look, dude, you can't just bite a yak.
Glad to see you made it back in one piece, Velvet.
I'm here on orders from the boss to help you guys out.
Oh, thank you.
We could certainly use it. How are things back in the city?
I came here from Helleves, so I don't know how far the suppression has progressed. But I can tell you that the Abbey's designated the area north of Helleves as a Class 4 administrative zone.
Which means they've pulled their forces out of the area.
What about the people of Mercio?
Everyone got out safe and sound, although they did petition for the extermination of the Lord of Calamity.
Of course.
I say we make this town our new hideout. When else are we ever gonna find a hideout that comes with hot springs?
That's a good idea. We should leave Kamoana and the others here.
Dial, could you stay and help them out?
As if you even had to ask.
Wow, that's surprisingly reliable for you, Dial.
Hey, that hurts. Now get going already. Benwick and the crew are making preparations in Helleves right now. Hey, Rokuro. How'd the showdown with your brother turn out?
I killed him. But I couldn't break Stormhowl.
Is that because Stormhowl was an even stronger sword than Kurigane's?
No. Even with Shigure's full strength behind it, Stormhowl didn't even leave a nick in Kurigane's blade. If I didn't have this sword, I'd be dead now. I think I just couldn't break Stormhowl because I'm still too inexperienced.
But you won the match, didn't you?
Yeah. But only by combining my techniques with Kurogane's craftsmanship.
If that's the case, then as long as you're wielding it, that sword is Stormquell. After all, Kurogane's sword did quell the Godblade's raging storm.
Do you think Kurogane would agree?
Are you kidding? You know how stubborn that guy is. He'd just say he'd forge something even stronger the next time. And that's why I say you shouldn't be satisfied with how you are either, Rokuro.
I know. I'll find even stronger opponents to cut down. By my hand, Kurogane's Stormquell will become even more legendary than Stormhowl ever was.
That's the spirit! Show them what we demons can do!
Yeah. Alright, is there anything else in town here? Yes, in the inn. Oh, hey! I've decided we should stay in this town for a while. I think it'll be safer that way. Yes, I agree. We just had a conversation back there, actually, about that, about having you guys stay here. If this is our new base, why do I have to pay you?
Grimoire, could we talk?
You sound so serious. Like it's the eve of the final battle.
Well, isn't it? Can't you let yourself get caught up in the moment for a change?
Getting caught up in the moment is for young, foolhardy lovers. So, what is it you want to talk about?
I just figured I should drop by since, well, like I said, the final battle with Inominat is coming up and all.
Ugh, you're talking like you're saying your last goodbyes.
It's just that we're up against a lot. Foggy Lou doesn't know what the future holds for us, and she almost always has that stuff figured out.
Whether she has it figured out or not, it is our lot in life to follow our vessels and fight to the very end.
That's what I've always thought, so I just dealt with Miss Moggy Lou's craziness up till now. But she's never thanked me for it. No, good job, Bianfu. No, I'm glad I'm your vessel. Not even something like, I'll introduce you to a cute girl when it's all over. It'd be nice to hear a little gratitude from her, even just once.
Surely you know she's not the type to do that sort of thing, though, yes?
That's all the more reason to want just one brief glimpse at who she is underneath.
If you're so unhappy, it's not too late to switch back to the Abbey's side and become an informant again.
What's the point in that? I don't know anything they'd want, and they wouldn't have any use for me there.
So you lack confidence in your own abilities?
Miss Moggy Lou has let me come with her wherever she went, and her talents have gotten us this far. But now that we have to fight Enominat, I'm worried. I don't know what use I could be for her, or if I can keep her safe.
But you'll still go, won't you?
Yeah, of course! Or else my name isn't Norman Brave!
See, you can do this. You've been keeping Moggy Lou safe this whole time. With all the emotional pain she's been through, she's needed someone as thick-skinned and tenacious as you. She may talk like she doesn't care, but she wouldn't have tracked you down and renewed your pact if she didn't.
When you put it like that, bien! All right, you've convinced me!
That's right. You just trust in old Norman therapist's good advice. It won't steer you wrong.
Wow! I'd have never expected you to actually make a joke like that, Grimoire!
I just thought I'd get caught up in the moment, like you wanted.
Okay!
That's right. Be confident, Bianfu. We can do this. Alright. Alright, time to go back to Helleby's, because there is stuff going on there as well. I love these dogs. I want these dogs. Orthy! Russ! You can't just sleep in front of the stove all day. You have to go outside and play with me. I'm sorry, did that dog just squee? That is not a normal noise for a dog. No wonder it's really hard. It unlocks all battle difficulties up to chaos. No wonder. My goodness. Okay. Away we go. Luckily, it's pretty much a short trip back. Boom. Thank you. see. Oh, the fresh air. Where it is not so frozen. Ooh, and plenty of scenes here.
You there, Exorcist! Do you know what happened to the Praetor, Lady Teresa? She used to be in charge here.
Oh, it's you.
Lady Teresa is the only one who can restore law and order in our town. Please, send a message to the Abbey. Tell them that the citizens of Hellevise are awaiting her return. Even if the Lord of Calamity herself were to attack, I won't budge until Lady Teresa returns to us.
What will refusing to move accomplish?
If my life is in danger, I know Lady Teresa will come to save me. Her, and that ice-cold glare of hers.
Teresa won't be coming back.
What?
If you really love Teresa, you shouldn't rely on her to protect you. You should become strong enough to protect her.
Whoa, that burning glare of yours. I think I like it.
Wait, what?
Okay. That guy has problems. Alright, anybody in here? Hello? No? Ah!
I heard that the Lord of Calamity appeared in Mercio. Now the whole town's been captured by demons.
What is the Abbey doing? Why don't exorcists come around here anymore?
The Abbey has abandoned us. If the Calamity shows up here, we're doomed. We either run or give up and drown ourselves in drink. If only Lady Teresa were still here.
Why has it come to this? Curse you, Lord of Calamity, for everything you've done!
You're quite the popular girl. Why not wave to your fans?
Yeah, that's a good idea.
I'm kind of assuming, because it's really crowded in here, I'm wondering if, you know, a lot of these people are from the other town. It's like, does nobody recognize her? Nobody?
We're planning evacuation routes. We need to be ready if the Calamity or demons show up in town.
When the Calamity attacked the first time, there was massive confusion. Some children got hurt in all the madness. We're preparing evacuation boats, so that we can all flee out to the sea if anything happens.
It's a good idea, but it will be hard to evacuate the entire town by boat. You'd best prepare a land route, too.
That's a good point. But wouldn't a land route run the risk of being attacked by demons?
Yes. You'll need to guard it as heavily as you do the city gates. It would be best if you could devise a way to prevent demons from intercepting the escape route, but...
Some of the exorcists lost use of their malachim. We can't count on the Abbey's garrison to help us.
I'll send a request for aid to the Abbey. But please, don't give up. Try to think of something.
Of course. There's no way we'll give up. You can't rely on someone else to protect you.
Can you really ask the Abbey for help?
I can send a Sylph-Jay to some of my old friends from when I was still in training. Even if they refuse to trust a traitor like me, they won't ignore the plight of the people here in Hellevise.
Well, that's at least nice. And, you know, I would certainly hope that they would help, but... they might not be able to if they don't have access to their, Malachim. So, guys might be on your own here.
How long are you going to sit there crying? You can't be a fisherman if you're afraid of some Lord of Calamity.
The demons that wrecked this town are still alive. Who knows when they'll show up again?
How about right now?
Sniveling idiot! Keep whining like that, and this Calamity whatever will keep walking all over you!
But what can we do? We can't even defeat a single demon.
That's why we take our boats, catch some fish, and make sure we've got enough food to keep on surviving. Didn't they drill anything into that fool head of yours in school? Ugh. Do I have to knock some sense into you? Get up and get the boat ready!
That is one hot-headed dad.
Too hot for any demons to get near. That's for sure.
It's a bit rough, but I kinda like him. Hey!
Welcome back! I take it you defeated the Legates.
Yes, but that still leaves Enominat and the Shepherd.
Onward ho to the last battle! Oh, I picked up something nice for you. Here.
Oh, why thank you?
An apple?
It's a fortune apple. A good luck charm. No real powers, but they're hard to find. Legend has it, they're pretty lucky.
A fortune apple.
But we're the bad guys, aren't we? Maybe what we need is bad luck instead.
We have Aizen with
us. Got that covered.
Aw, that's just mean.
Well, I appreciate the thought. Thanks, Benwick. I love apples.
Just don't eat it.
I couldn't eat it, even if I wanted. Wait a moment. That's right. My power to consume is a part of Enominat. If that's true, then...
What is it?
You want a bite? Delicious fortune apple.
No way. That's a good luck charm.
That it is. One to give you the courage you need to survive.
So, where's our final destination?
The Empyrean's throne.
Sail for Port Zexon.
Not yet.
Aye, aye, ma'am. Aye, aye, sir.
We have things to do.
Do you think that with Enominat's power waning, people will be free again?
Well, the pirates are acting like pirates again. May take longer for others, but I think it's happening.
What do you think of traveling around to see for ourselves? I'd like to know what's going on out there.
I'd like to meet the elemental Empyreans, if I could.
That's not a great idea. They're all in various Earth Pulse points, but where those are is a mystery. They could be very far off.
And they might not view us as allies.
That's okay.
Gods live by their own rules. Our business with Enominat probably doesn't concern them.
You're right.
It might be wise to scope out the situation before our battle. As we go around, we might find out more about what Artorias is up to.
Excellent.
Just don't eat him. Got it?
I won't. Don't worry.
Hey, Rokuro! I heard about a Class 4 island that sounds damn near perfect for you.
Really?
An island that's perfect for me. Do the rivers flow with good drink?
Now that you mention it. But no, different island. I'm talking about you as a swordsman. The demons there all run around the island in suits of armor and helmets and stuff, I hear.
Armored demons are not unusual.
Yeah, but what I heard tell was that all the exorcists who got sent there came back with their swords broken. I don't know if they've got swords too, or if their armor is just that strong, but I reckon your sword will be able to stand up to them.
Well then, I've heard worse ideas.
If you believe the tales, that island used to be a place where swordsmen and knights competed to see who was stronger.
Oh yeah, I know the island you're talking about. Craftsmen from all over gave their finest weapons and armor to the greatest of warriors and made them fight. It was as much a showcase for those wares as it was a contest of strength.
So the demons on that island might come at us wielding fine arms and armor.
I'm certainly up for checking it out. I'm curious to see how good the stuff really is.
After all I've told you, you still want to go? What is wrong with you?
What's wrong with you? Why would you want to go there? Do you not know us? All right. We have places to go. I don't want to go to Port Zexon. Well, fine. I'll deal with these first, I guess. Come on, demons.
Not worth my time.
Ow! Ew! Don't throw up on me! Gross!
Yeah.
punch me either. One down. I think there's one more of these. Yep. I really wish it would let me go other places before I head off to the quote-unquote final battle area. So this is the one where we have armored guys.
Move it or die.
Whoa! That's not what I was expecting.
Let's go.
Ow! Whoa! What the heck happened? Oh my god, bugs!
Come on!
angry lizards. Jeez. Can I move, please? My goodness, I got a ton of stuff. Ooh, well that's nice. So many shoes. Wow. All right, well if I'm not allowed to go anywhere else, I guess I'll go to Port Zexon. Does not make me happy.
So, what was it you needed to say to me alone?
Where's Lafayette?
He wanted to stand watch with me, but I forced him to get some rest. After all this fighting, he needs it.
Sure he does.
I owe you. That kid always tries to play the tough guy.
Just like the one who named him.
He's nothing like me. His motivation comes from hope.
Hope.
The wind is nice.
Yes, the world may teem with hardship and sadness, but it's also filled with beauty. The endless ocean. The islands in the south, even the frozen tundra and the mountains that spew fire.
It is. And humans make their home among all that beauty. This is the world that Laffy always yearned to travel. I finally understand what he saw when he sat looking out over the ocean.
Eleanor, I have a single favor to ask of you. If anything happens to me, take care of Lafayette.
What? Is something the matter?
The power possessed by the Therians and Innominat is fundamentally the same. I have a theory. No, theory is too rational. A different part of me, something separate from my hatred, wants me to do something. It wants me to leave this world with hope.
Wait, you don't mean...
Humor me, okay? If the worst happens, I'm counting on you.
I understand. You have my word. I'll look after Lafayette. While I'd love to take advantage of this momentary weakness, I can't. My oath is to obey your orders until my dying breath.
I'd almost forgotten about all that. Good thing I kicked your butt after all.
Well, while I'd like to hope that something bad will not happen, in fact, it's more likely that it will. Which is sad.
Well, the suppression field is gone.
And in its place, rampaging demons.
We expected that. Thanks for everything.
I only did what I felt like doing. Who needs thanks for that?
Let's go. We have a fight to finish with the Shepherd.
Can I turn around and leave?
Innominat's power may have weakened, but I think that'll only cause more of a stir in the cities.
Without the Abbey's exorcists, the people will have a hard time quelling demons.
Are you crying?
I'm simply coming to terms with reality. I've learned to think for myself rather than let others do the thinking for me. It's painful and frightening, and comes with great responsibility. But this is who I am now. It's on me to own up, face my fears, and keep moving forward.
You're a piece of work, but I don't mind having you around.
Yes, I'm not weak like I used to be.
No, you aren't.
You don't have to bear the weight of the world alone, though.
I understand that. I will do only what I can.
You always say that, but then you end up overdoing it, right? If you push yourself to the limit and it's still not enough, there's no shame in relying on others.
Rokuro, thank you so much.
You realize you just thanked a demon, right?
I'm aware of that.
Okay, yes, I'm allowed. Am I allowed to leave? Am I really allowed to leave? I am! Okay, there's places I need to go. I know that there's scenes and everything here, but we'll do that when we come back here finally. There are things to do, definitely. Like here.
There's a class 4 island that folks were too afraid to go near even before the demons showed up.
Really?
If there weren't any demons, what was so scary?
Well, the guy who owned the island was a real lowlife. They say he'd take a bunch of lawbreakers out there and make them kill each other.
Bien. Crimes or not, that's terrible.
The seas near the island ran red with the blood of the convicts. Hell. You could even smell it in the air. Folks say that even now, on nights when the sea turns red under the light of the crimson moon, the prisoner's spirits return to the island. You ask me? I bet that those demons are reincarnations of the dead prisoners. If you go there, you'd best be careful.
I'd rather just stay far, far away.
Really? Well... Oh, hello. And what is going on over here? Hello.
I heard about some Abbey people who went to recon a class 4 island. And haven't come back.
Oh? I wonder what's drawn their gaze.
Well, recently, a fishing boat carrying daemons washed up in the harbor and caused a real stir.
The crew just probably caught daemon blight, right?
Well, about that. People found flowers on the ship that only bloom on that there Class 4 island. But even if the fishermen had gone near the island, they weren't the types who'd ever even consider setting foot on its shore.
Could the daemons have attacked the ship, then ridden it all the way to the harbor in search of more prey?
The daemons were wolfmen-looking guys. Certainly got the Abbey on alert. A whole bunch of intelligent daemons is bad news.
Wolfmen? An island of Therians? I'd say that place ranks sixth on the places where I'd least want to live.
Wait, what the hell kinds of places are 1 through 5?
That's a good question. Well, since we've been given access to more administrative zones, why not go visit them and kick some demon butt as well? Wait. There we go. Apparently, I missed some. Okay. The undead quarter. I wonder if you get anything awesome for having done all of these.
We can do this.
I definitely got here a little bit late.
Good luck, Al.
Show him.
That was much easier than the last one I went to. But that's always kind of nice when it's easy. Okay. And this is the demi-human one. All right. Oh, you know, I had forgotten entirely that there were cat's boxes on these islands. I don't think I have enough to really open one. Oh, I had just enough. I'm not surprised that I barely had any. I need to go on a long, long hunt for orbs.
We can do this.
Hello? Ow! Oh, yeah. These guys hit really hard.
Let's go.
I didn't. Have you no faith? Ooh, blood blade. Wow. Ooh, blood blade. What was I so excited for? Anything we haven't worn yet. So many clothes. Ugh. Everybody's wearing the clothes I want. Okay, let's see now. Where else do we need to go? We do need to go to Abel. I'm not sure about anywhere else, but... we still can't go to Titania? Huh. Well, let's go to Taliesin. Taliesin, sorry. Looks like there's at least something here as well.
Is the world gonna be destroyed by the bad guys? By this calamity monster?
Yes.
What'd I tell you about asking weird questions to strangers? Sorry, he's a real handful.
I don't mind. My little brother was full of curiosity, too. Always asking everyone all sorts of questions.
Oh, is this your brother?
No, I'm not.
So the world's gonna be destroyed?
What would you say if I said yes?
I don't want to be destroyed! I want to be a pirate and explore the world, and I wouldn't be able to have my sister's meatballs anymore!
Not the meatballs!
So, what will you do about it?
I'll stop that monster! I'll protect my sister!
Then you'll need to get stronger. The Lord of Calamity is really tough.
Stronger than a demon or a dragon?
You bet. But you'll still fight her?
I will!
Good answer. As a reward, I'll give you a good tip. If you want to get stronger, you'll need to get your own compass first.
A compass? Isn't that for ships? That'll make me stronger?
Yes. I know a boy who found a compass. With it, he traveled the world and got really strong.
Wow. I'll find the compass and get strong too.
Aww. That's adorable. Probably embarrassing the crap out of Lafayette right now. Ooh, even more going on up here. But given the time, we're going to wait until the next episode to finish up what's in here and then head for Abel. So thanks everyone for watching, and I'll see you then. Bye!